Hello, I'm back. So I decided to build a drop pod for the command squad or and the commander Loken. Anyways, instead of building a regular drop pod, I decided to try out a tutorial to build to do a conversion for a Dreadclaw drop pod out of an ordinary drop pod kit. I'll put a link to the tutorial down below, but I just thought I'd share some thoughts of my own, and perhaps it will help someone if they would like to do the same thing. So yeah, let's get to it. So for you that has built a drop pod, you can recognize this sketch. This is the instructions. Basically, what you do is you build the bottom part of the drop pod just as the instructions tell you to. You can skip these parts here, the inside, because the drop pod won't open up, and you can also skip the insides of the doors because it will all be glued shut. So you build up the bottom part. And then you do the top engine part as well. Skip you don't need this weapon mount and stuff on the inside, as I said. And then you will get to this stage. As you can see, this is the outer part of the doors. Mounted to the bottom plate as ordinary, and this is the top engine part, the engine stack or whatever you want to call them, with the side panels as well inside there. There's a little square bit that goes to that tube thing. And what you then do is you glue the doors shut, the outside doors, and you glue them to the square parts on the top there. As you can see, perhaps if this camera, yeah, there you go. This is a bit tricky, as you can see, messed up a bit on some of the parts, but that won't show that much, so I'll fix that later on. And then you have these cracks, whatever you want to call them, and that's where you will put on the fins. Sorry. And if we just change the page here, this is how they look in their ordinary configuration. And they would go with the circular part downwards and have a slant towards the top of the drop pod. But the Dreadclaw actually has this turned around, and you have to modify this part as well a little bit. This is what is usually the bottom part in the ordinary drop pod, but will become the top part on the Dreadclaw. This piece goes up a little further than this, makes a little corner like that, and you have to cut it off, as you can see, from the top of this pipe and follow the line. Maybe you can see there where I made a cut. Follow the line from the top of the pipe to where the original part is. Just you get a clean straight cut from there. Yes. And then on the bottom part, on the middle part, I should say, there's another corner here. You can see this long straight part here. There's actually an angular piece, a corner that goes out right here, and you need to cut that off as well and make it so it makes it all the way down in a straight pattern. And then this is optional, of course. This is the bottom part, and come on, focus. And it goes down a little bit further down here and makes it into just below that bolt there. But to get a better look, you can cut it more at an angle to get that claw look. Hard to describe, but when you're sitting with the piece, you can, and look at the tutorial as well, you could probably figure out how you want to do that, how steep you want the angle and such, and then just mark it out. And I used the Games Workshop detail saw to cut that piece off. So yeah, that's, and you do this with all the thin parts. Then I'm gonna try and show you this. A little bit tricky. This is gonna be hard to do with one hand, but just have to bear with me. I'm gonna try and fix the camera here. So, as I said, originally they would go on something like that, with this round piece to the top of the drop pod. But in this configuration, you will a bit confused. It would go originally, it would be put down like this or something, with the circular piece to the bottom of the drop pod. But now we have cut the piece, so it will fit in like that. Can you see that? A little bit hard on this camera. Yeah, into the groove here on the side, and just put it in, and it should glue into the piece, something like that. I think you can, well, you can decide how much you want it to actually point up here. I think I'm gonna put it like that. There's a little lip here because of the two parts that are glued together, and I will put this corner here up against the lip. That will give it something like that. And then you do that on all the parts, and I will be back when I've actually glued them on to show you what it will look like. And when you have done that, you can then detail the kit in whatever way you like. The guide suggests putting the smaller thrusters that are usually, I think they are in here on the original kit, probably in those grooves there. He put them on the outside here as guiding thrusters for the Dreadclaw. But I think you can do whatever you want with that part. What I'm thinking of, you might not know, the Dreadclaw drop pod, the usual one drops down and the doors blast open to the side and the guys inside exits. On the Dreadclaw, they actually exit from the bottom part. There's a circular hatch thing down here that opens up, and I'm not sure if they jump down or if there's some kind of elevator thingy, but that's not important. What I'm thinking of doing is actually fabricating a part for this area here with the round hatch, just to do it. It will land like this on the tabletop, that part will probably not be shown much anyway, but I just want to try and do it. It looks like there would be some good points to glue a sheet of plastic card down here and just put the detail on there. So I'm gonna try that out as well. So I will be back with another update when I finish gluing on the parts, and see you then. Bye.